Okay, so time-lapse photography is when you take a lot of pictures over a long period of time, say like once every couple seconds or maybe once a minute, once every 10 minutes on your camera, and then you take all of those pictures and you put them into a video editing program and you make each picture that you've taken one frame from a video. So you're essentially playing back these pictures you took once every 10 seconds or once every 2 minutes and playing them at 24 frames per second. So you get an interesting perception or misperception of what time is, and you see clouds moving really quickly, stars spinning through the sky around the earth, and the sun moving with shadows all over the place. So you get this really cool concept of what is time and this thing that looks really, really nice at the end. So we're gonna show you how to make those. We're going to be showing you how to set up your camera for time-lapse photography, whether you're using a DSLR, Canon or Nikon, a point-and-shoot, or even a GoPro. We're going to go over things like how to take photographs for your time-lapse and then how to edit them on the computer. And we're going to go over both GoPro for GoPro users, Nikon users, and Canon users, and we're going to share with you some secret tips of the trade that we've learned so far. So without further ado, here's how you set up your camera. Okay, so here we have a very basic setup of a camera taking some time-lapse photographs. You'll notice that some of the basic equipment that we use to set this up is just a pretty sturdy tripod and the camera, along with an additional shutter release remote that we're using so we don't have to press the shutter button ourselves, which could possibly cause shake in the tripod, and it's just easier to let it take the pictures itself. So this is some of the basic stuff you'll need. You'll definitely need a tripod, and if you want to make your life easy, you should probably consider investing in a shutter release remote. But you don't need to use a DSLR to do this. You could, again, like we said earlier, you could use a GoPro, which actually doesn't require a shutter release remote. It has a built-in program to take the photographs for you. Nikons, you could use intervalometers. Canons have those too, but they're usually on the higher end cameras. And even point-and-shoots sometimes have time-lapse programs built into them, as well as some smartphones. So this is the basic setup. You'll just want to have a tripod and a nicely composed scene, and just let the camera do the work for you. Okay, so now we're going to show you a little bit more in detail how to properly set your camera up to take photographs. So as I said before, you're going to need a sturdy tripod. And if you're using a DSLR, you'll probably want a shutter release remote. I'm already taking this time lapse, so you can see here the orange indicates that I'm locked in, and my picture will just keep taking pictures continuously until I unlock this shutter release remote. So I'm just going to place that to the side and describe what kind of settings I'm using here. Whenever you're using a DSLR or a camera that allows you to change the exposure settings on your camera, you're going to want to switch to manual mode. And you're just going to want to gauge what kind of lighting the setting it has, and you're going to want to expose based off of that. So right now I'm actually using a neutral density filter, which we covered in another video of ours, like what those do and how those can help. And I'm using it today because it's a little bit too bright outside and I need a longer exposure. So my exposure settings right now are at ISO 100, exposure of 30 seconds, and an aperture of 4. So some of the things you're going to want to set onto your camera are: you're going to want to switch to JPEG instead of being on RAW, because RAW files will end up eating way too much space from on your card, of course, because you're taking more hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of these pictures. As for an example, the last time I was taking a time-lapse video, I took 600 pictures, which probably would not fit on my 8GB SD card if I had shot in RAW. So I'm actually shooting in JPEG LAR, so definitely switch to JPEG when you're doing time-lapse photography. Another thing to keep in mind is to keep your drive mode on continuous, because that way when you lock your shutter release remote, it's going to take picture after picture. If you had only on single shot, it would only take one picture, and despite the fact that you're locked in on your shutter release remote, it would not take another picture after that. That's something that's really easy to forget, and you might actually accidentally leave your camera sitting there for an hour thinking it's taking a time-lapse video. and it won't be when you come back. What else is there? There is your focusing. You should always manually focus when you do these things. Typically, for nighttime photographs, you'll be at infinity to make sure you get a clear view of the stars in the Milky Way. Right now, I'm not at infinity because I'm just taking a video of this fountain here. One last thing you want to remember is to always set your white balance. Right now, it's a little bit before sunset, but I'm still on daylight. Sometimes you can get away with using automatic, especially if you have changing light conditions, so you don't see the color change. But definitely remember to set your white balance before you take your photographs, because as I said before, you're shooting in JPEG, and it's hard to edit the white balance of JPEG files. It's much easier to do in RAW, so it's an annoying thing to fix if you accidentally forget to set it. You see this? Whoa. Go back straight up, I want to see.
Alright, so for a Nikon camera, instead of using one of those remotes, if you have one of the newer cameras or a fancier camera like this D300S, you can actually go to a special feature in the camera to take time-lapse pictures. Go to your shooting menu, then all the way near the bottom, or at the very bottom in this case, you have this thing called interval timer shooting. So you go into the interval timer shooting, and I have this on from an earlier time, but you go into interval timer shooting, and this is where you pick your interval, right? So right here it says 7 seconds. That means that this camera will take a picture every 7 seconds. So say I wanted to do a 30 second exposure, I would bring this up to a bit more than 30 seconds so that the camera would have time to take the pictures, right? Because it basically just sends a message to the shutter button once every 30 seconds to take a picture. And if the camera is not taking a picture already, it'll take the picture. So this will take a picture once every 32 seconds. And this is how many shots, right? Right now I have it set to just take 944 of these intervals and take one picture at every interval. If I say two or three here, it'll take three pictures every 30 seconds or something like that. So what I normally do is just put this to a really high number, right? Because then you can just leave this on overnight. It'll just keep going and going and going, right? Like you just hit start, timer gets active, and then you can listen. You'll hear it start taking pictures, right? There's no lens on this now, but it'll just take a picture once every 30 seconds until it either finishes its count, which you'll see after the picture gets taken and you see it's flashing interval there, or until you turn the camera off. So that's how you set this up on a Nikon. You don't need any of the timers as long as you have a Nikon that has this interval timer shooting.
Okay. So now we're going to go over how to take time-lapse videos with your GoPro. Just a quick note, most GoPros nowadays don't come with a tripod attachment, so you might want to invest in that if you're actually going to seriously use your GoPro for some time-lapse footage. But anyway, you're going to turn your GoPro on, which I've already done here, and you're going to switch modes until you see this symbol. It's a little camera with a timer, and that's just your time-lapse shooting mode. You can see here that I previously had it set to 60 seconds at 11 megapixels, and I have already taken 69 pictures with it. I'll show you some sample footage that I've taken with this GoPro already. But if you want to change it from 60 seconds to another time, you're going to want to go into your settings menu. So you find this little wrench, you press the top red button to go through the menu settings, and you can see here, so you're going to go to this little menu. You see it says 60 seconds, and all you really have control over is how much time goes in between each photograph, the maximum being 60 seconds. But you can go as fast as 0.5 seconds, all the way up to 60 seconds. So all you really want to do with your GoPro is just select how much time you want in between each photograph, then go back to the time-lapse shooting menu by clicking the modes. First you're going to want to exit the settings menu by finding exit, pressing the button, and then going back into the time-lapse shooting mode here, and you'll see that I have switched it to 5 seconds. So all you really want to do is just place your GoPro down somewhere, press the record button, and it'll just keep going until it runs out of memory, battery, or until you stop it. And that is how to use a GoPro. Most point-and-shoots have a similar style of time-lapse
shooting. They just have a program where you select how much time goes in between each picture, and that's how point and shoots work too. We're not going to go over those in this video just because they work in a very similar fashion to the GoPro, as well as many apps on your iPhone or other smartphone devices. But that's just the basic gist of how to use a time-lapse shooting program that you can find on a GoPro and other cameras.
Whether you have a Nikon or a Canon, if you don't have an intervalometer built into your camera, you're going to have an issue with getting the timing to work out for your time lapse. So my recommendation for this is to either buy an intervalometer or buy a neutral density filter. This is what Roman does, and this is how using a remote with your continuous release lockdown works. If you have a neutral density filter that lets you take 5-second exposures in broad daylight, then you'll be taking one picture every 5 seconds with a continuous release. Otherwise, buying a remote timer that has an intervalometer on it, which is what I mean when I say buy an intervalometer, will do the timing aspect for you outside of your camera, so you'll be back to taking a picture once every 10 seconds, 20 seconds, or however long you want. So there are always workarounds if you don't have these features built into your camera or GoPro or point and shoot.
Alright, so a large part of time-lapse photography is having the dedication to go to different areas to take your time-lapse photographs. Right now it's 3:17 in the morning and we're heading to Cape Henlopen in Delaware, which was about 2 hours away from where we live. And we're hoping to get a nice time-lapse of the sunrise because we're on the East Coast here. So definitely be prepared to put in the hours if you want to make a time-lapse video.
Alright, so one thing that we do want to cover before we end this video is something about histograms. So this is what you want to look at before you start your time lapse, especially if you're doing a time lapse of something where you're going to have variable lighting conditions like a sunrise or a sunset or a moonset. Basically, you want to start with your exposure purposely wrong
so that you get the most amount of usable video. That is, if you're doing a sunrise, you want to purposely start your footage really underexposed, so your histogram is skewed to the left, so that when the sun does finally rise, it ends up looking normally exposed, and you get a lot of usable footage.
Now, when we say really underexposed, just make sure you're not getting any clipping, because then you're losing detail, and you still want to retain the detail. Another topic, as we move on here, are just tips to save battery life. You want to turn the image brightness, or the LCD brightness on your screen down. You want to turn off silent shooting mode, because that also wastes battery. And you want to turn off image review, so your screen isn't constantly turning on and off after every single picture, which also helps to save battery.
Some other things that you want to watch out for during prolonged time-lapse exposure is condensation growing on your lens, like dew forming on the front of your camera. And this happens when your equipment gets really cold, like all the grass and stuff on the ground. So to fix this, you want to use hand warmers inside of socks, and then you wrap those socks around your lens and fasten them on with rubber bands, and that'll keep your lens warm overnight.
Just be careful when you do that, because sometimes when you're putting the sock on, you might accidentally shift the focus on your lens. So if you already focused, make sure to check your focus after you do that. Another thing I want to mention really quickly is, I know we didn't cover everything in this video, and as a result, we're going to do a follow-up video of any questions or frequently asked questions that you guys have in a separate video. If you want to see some sample time-lapse photography that we've done, we do have two videos on our channel.
Pop up here somewhere.
Yeah, they'll pop up. It'll be interesting to see, you know, how our time-lapse photography has changed. And finally, just thank you for watching this video. If you liked it, subscribe to be notified when our next time-lapse video comes out, because we are working on one. It's going to come out at the end of summer. We also do have a blog. If you want to subscribe to that instead, feel free to do so.
And the blog is going to have a written-up article posted along with this video that's going to kind of explain everything in words if you want it, just in writing. And it's also going to include a lot of links for helpful things for time-lapse photography, like tripods, intervalometers, hand warmers, things that we recommend. But those links will also be down in the description below.
All right, I think we mentioned just about everything. Again, if you have any questions, we'll answer them in a follow-up video. But thank you for watching. This is Connor and Roman's Rabbit Visions.
I think we're good on stock footage.